Sup, nerds? We're back again with Costume Quest. We're gonna try to get this game. We're gonna try to see this game to the end, man. We're gonna try to see it all the way to the end.
That's the challenge, but I already forgot how to play. How do I see the
changing? Like, the costume changes?
No, like, I forgot what it was. It let you see the...
objectives?
The quest, the objectives.
Yes. I think, like, maybe select or start.
Was it select or start?
Well... Up there. You can just hit the right trigger and the left trigger, and then it'll change it to a quest.
There it is, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you have to find the kids, remember? You have to trick-or-treat the house, go after Reynolds.
Okay, there you go. So, damn it. There you go. That's what I wanted to do.
Yeah, so, I don't know if you guys, any of you guys own, like, one of the, both, either the GameStop Xbox controller that you can buy for like maybe $15 or something like that, and the actual Xbox controller, but there is a noticeable difference, and the GameStop one that I bought seemed to break somewhat fast. Now it did last me a while, but I didn't use it as much as I would have liked to. Yeah, so eventually I'm gonna need to upgrade because the buttons feel it just doesn't feel right. Canada's control is the actual Xbox one, it feels better.
Well, 360, but it's pretty good. Recommend. Well,
I want to get the Xbox One because it looks like it feels awesome. The joysticks, they look more, I don't really know, comfortable. I don't know what the right word is, if I'm honest.
How's the PS4 ones? Is there any difference between that and the...
The last time I played, I think, was when we were like at a friend's place, and... it felt different. It felt bigger in your hand, which was okay. If anything, it was a welcome change, because usually the PlayStation 3, PlayStation 2 controllers were somewhat... they're smaller compared to the Xbox One. The joysticks did feel different, and I welcomed that too, because it was more comforting. I was reading that, and I have no idea what she was talking about, honestly. I'm lost in terms of plot, guys.
Yeah, I don't know what battle stamps are, but I guess I need some.
There's a thing up there, a chest. You just passed. You can hit the kids right there.
What is that, a hot dog thing or a candy?
Oh, you got candy, apparently. Man, for Halloween one year, my mom used to work at this very, like, in this very nice neighborhood where most of the people, most of the people that lived there were very wealthy, for lack of a better term. And you've never seen kids more out of place than when like a bunch of like Hispanic middle class kids are just walking around like a high class neighborhood trick-or-treating in the cheapest looking costumes. And there's a bunch of freaking people walking around. You have what are they? Oh, I think it started us a little bit before, because you found that kid the last time as well.
Did it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I had two. Uh-huh.
So for example, like a friend of ours, right? My brother's friend, which for whatever reason, you know, my brother decided when they were younger and in middle school that they were gonna give each other nicknames, and they gave each other nicknames that make no sense to me whatsoever. So one of my brother's friends, who they call Yogurt, was dressed up like a hot dog with, no, not a hot dog, it was an ostrich. So he was wearing the inflatable ostrich while he skateboarded around, so it looked like it was an ostrich. Like, he was riding an ostrich that was skateboarding around. And the part that made it funny was, it eventually, the motor that powered the whole thing just died. And so then he's walking around with a deflated ostrich around his waist, trick-or-treating, and a bunch of people are just giving him looks like, what the hell is he supposed to be? Because at that point, it lost its shape and form. So it just looked like, I don't even know, it just looked like a mess, like a baggy mess under his pants. And it was one of the more funnier things I'd ever seen, because I'm telling you, like, high-class people just walking around like, they can't, oh my god, these kids, they can't seem to afford working costumes.
See, I couldn't afford not even that deflated costume. All I would buy is a fucking mask. A Jason mask. I think a Michael Myers mask at one point.
Man, when I was a kid...
Oh, the Scream mask. That's the Scream mask. Everybody
that's
wanted.
The one. And no, it was even better blood? If it had the blood. That's what I was about to say. When I was a kid, I begged my parents to buy me it. And they did, too. Like, my mom... out of, you know... These are two hardworking Hispanics. You know what I mean? Like, they... they came from their country and they've been working really hard to give us a good living, and they've done very well so far. But right, as a kid, I'm not aware of all these things. I begged them to buy me that thing. It was one of the more expensive gifts because you had to pump the blood, and it pumped blood around the mask, and I was dying for it, and they bought it for me eventually one year, and I didn't even wear it for long. I took it off and left it there because I hate masks, it turns out, on costumes, because they're so incredibly hot. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's why I can't use hats for too long. I get really hot.
I got used to using hats, and I can use them even better now that I'm bald because I used to have hair. I haven't shaved in a couple of days, so it's actually starting to look fuzzy on my head, but...
He keeps making me go talk to Sadie. I think he has a crush on her.
I think he has a crush on her.
He's trying to get it in.
He's trying to get it in, dude. That's not appropriate for their age, man.
Hey, have you seen... I don't know about your guys' places, but here in Miami, it's a bunch of middle school kids, elementary school kids that are already in
relationships. It's terrifying. It is terrifying to live here in Miami, where kids are under the impression that because they're in Miami, they can go ahead and wear just like the smallest articles of clothing, and the parents don't do anything about it, because you can go to a movie theater here, right, and it's a Friday or a Saturday, and you have a bunch of middle school kids walking around, and like guys are in skinny jeans and girls are wearing practically nothing, and as an adult you have to try to like just avert your eyes. And I say try, not because it pulls you in the general direction, but more because if you're not looking where you're going, you're gonna murder yourself, and they're pretty much everywhere. You know what I mean? Like, you're trying to walk up the stairs and there's a middle schooler in front of you, and it's all of a sudden you look like a pervert because everybody's like, is he trying to look up her skirt? When you're just trying to make sure you don't miss the next step, fumble and die. Oh, which reminds me, at the what is it? I think it was the Florida Supercon, right? That we went to recently this weekend, or the previous weekend. One of these weekends, we went to the Florida Supercon. I went as a Spartan, right? And the whole idea, right? Originally, what it was supposed to be, which, I mean, we thought it was clever, but I'm well aware that it's probably been done several times before, is we were gonna go as Spartans from Halo, but we were gonna take a sword and shield so we could also be Spartans from 300, right? Now your cousin Michael, right, who might show up every now and then on NerdsPlay, he ended up forgetting the sword and shield, so we went as regular old Spartans, and the part that sucked is if you get the ones with the snake, you don't get points at all, I think. And then if you get the rotten ones, like the ones that are already eaten, you lose points as well, I think. You have to get like the green ones or the red ones. Yeah. Right, so Spartans. The part that was funny was that same weekend, the Halo, or the during the week, at some point during the week, the Halo like anniversary edition had come out. It had just been released. Mm-hmm. And the fact that it was released meant that we were going to have to... not that we were going to have to do anything, but it looked like we were celebrating the anniversary, like the release of the anniversary. So we showed up looking at Spartans. But the one thing that did salvage it was the fact that we went as red, at red versus blue, which most people got. Other people just thought we were Spartans. It didn't really matter to us all together. We posed for pictures with everyone who stopped us, and we got stopped a lot. Actually, like, we got stopped a considerable amount. But the one issue about wearing the costume, and I have like a great, like, I appreciate anyone who does it religiously anytime that there's a con, either in Florida or anywhere where they live. The one issue we had was it's really hard to see where you're going with a mask like that on. You know what I mean? Like you're trying to go up an escalator, and you don't know that you're placing your feet on the step, because you know initially escalators they're down, and then when you place your foot on it is when it goes back up, like when it's as it goes upward. So like when you step on it, you assume you're on a leveled ground, and then all of a sudden the step comes up, and it turns out the back half of your foot wasn't on it, and you start to topple over backwards, so you hold on for dear life, and that mask doesn't go all the way down, like it's a helmet, so the helmet sort of it kind of like encases your head, and as you're trying to look down, you're looking into the helmet as opposed to looking on the ground. You have to grab the helmet and make it go down as well. And it doesn't help that the entire time underneath we were wearing ski masks because I was trying to hide my beard so it wouldn't, you couldn't see it. So
both of you had the same helmet?
Yeah, except his whole costume was blue and I was red.
I thought it was maybe a little different. So both of you guys were blind?
Yeah, we were both blind. We had, my wife was with us, right? Kenya, she was with us. And we had her pretty much tell us which way to go, whether we were, you know, going to run into anything, if we were heading in the right direction, stuff like that. Michael's friends were there too, and they were also helping us, like they were guiding us as well. But the thing about cons is they get so packed that you lose the people you're with if you're not paying attention. So you can't, like the mask we were wearing, you can't see that well out of your peripherals. So as we're walking through the crowd, we would just lose people. Like I wouldn't know where any of them went. And so every so often, the only way I could find Michael is because, you know, he's tall. Michael's pretty tall.
And you just see the
You just see like a blue halo mask standing above the crowd, and you're like, there he is. Other than that, I wouldn't have been able to find him.
Did you dare just run up and hug him, and then it turns out it wasn't him?
No, because then it turns out it wasn't him, and I get punched in the face. It's a big difference, though, like when, and because, all right, so we've also been to the New York Comic Con, and we went recently. It was the first time we went. We went this year, and it was a great experience, and it was fun, but it's a big difference, the New York Comic Con, from the Florida SuperCon that's being held here, or the one that used to be held at FIU as well, because, like, it gets pretty packed, but it doesn't get as packed as the New York Comic Con does, which it seems like an obvious statement, you know, but to some people, they're unaware of that, of the fact, because they've never been to a lot of cons, so they assume that that's just generally what it's like. But on a massive scale, like the New York one, we wanted to go into certain panels, and it was impossible to get in. You had to be there, right? If you wanted to get in, I wanted to go into the Dan Harmon panel, I think it was that one. It's the guy who did Community and stuff like that.
All right.
To get in, if it started at 6, we had to be making the line at 1. Just so we can get tickets, because, you know, you have to get, like, the little wristband that lets them know that you can go in, right? And then, just to make sure you had seats, you maybe had to go in during the panel before. Because that's what happens, is if that auditorium is being used for, like, a panel beforehand, the people that are in there, they'll just stay there for the following one. And some people will even go into the previous one just so that they can save themselves a seat.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it ends up being, like, overly packed and the people don't leave. And then you end up missing, like, a seat or something like that. You can't make it.
Here in Miami, you just go in and...
Pretty much, yeah. We basically walked into everything. We were like, oh, look, seats. And we sat at the front. We were pretty much, like, near the cosplayers that were doing their... you use your shield, I think. So you swap over, use the shield to block the water, and you can walk through it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Forgot he had that.
There you go. You can stop it now. But it was a pretty fun experience. There's a lot of people. People are pretty cool. A lot of brave girls. You know what I mean? Like, I'm a woman lover. I love all shapes and sizes. It doesn't bother me. But I'm chunky, and I'm self-conscious about the clothes I wear when I go out. These girls were wearing pretty much, like, a thong and a top. Some women dressed as Poison Ivy, and it looks like they went out, picked up Poison Ivy, and just put it on their body. You know what I mean? And then they're walking around just, like, covering a nipple and the vagina. And it was all shapes and sizes, too. You know, skinny girls and big girls just walking around that way. And I was like, man, brave girls, because I could not, for the life of me, I would not be able to. You know what I mean?
What about guys? Were there guys in those kind of revealing costumes? Like, for example, the tight pants? For example?
Well, there's a lot of people who wear, like, skin-tight suits.
Exactly, those.
Yeah, they wear those. There were a couple people, you know, like, the more obvious one is Deadpool. There was a Spider-Man that we were like, man, that guy is, like, super skinny. And he was just wearing it. You could see the bulge and everything. Just, like, super tight. There was one dude who showed up as, like, Venom. And it pretty much looked like he was just, like, he painted it on himself. I have a lot more to talk about, but I'll talk about it next time on the next episode, because we're out of time this time. So we're going to stop here and we'll continue next time, guys.
We'll see where the other kids are. They're hiding it really well.
They're expert hiders. And I'll tell you, Kenneth is like hide and seek champion of the year. So
yeah, we'll leave it off here.
All right, guys. See you next time.